I just played an Uptown that, and we got another Uptown artist right here on the phone. With me is Nesto Velasquez. He had a single out around 93 called Personality, and you get to find out more about him. Nesto, welcome to the Time Machine, my man.
Hey, how you doing?
I appreciate you calling up and doing this interview with me, my man.
No problem. Thank you.
All right, now go ahead and tell the people, how did you get your start singing prior to getting signed to Uptown?
Actually, my father used to sing, and I guess I got that from him. And I was always into music. I went to performing arts, and one of the things that I've always loved was a lot of old soulful joints, like Stevie, Donny Hathaway, and I used to sing it like all the time. And at one time, I was singing on in New York City at a subway station, just singing, and someone happened to see me, and from there, that's where everything took off. They introduced me to the person that managed me, Andre Harrell and Russell Simmons, and that's how everything started.
Okay, so basically, you grew up listening to a lot of music like R&B, hip hop, a lot of traditional Latin music, right?
Yeah. Yep.
Okay, now tell me about your history with this group that was just on my show, Boys Del Barrio, but they went by Barrio Boys back in the day.
Right. The Barrio Boys, actually, I was supposed to be one of the original lead singers. I knew the manager before the group. He approached me. He knew, of me. And he was talking about how he started doing jackets. He was called Joe Jackets because he used to do these brown rhinestone jackets for different artists. And one of his accounts were the New Kids on the Block. And his dream was to make, put together a group that sung Spanish and English, with the same type of, music and audience that the New Kids on the Block had. And he approached me with the offer, and I took it at first. But things started kind of moving a little too slow, and Uptown had offered me the contract for, anything solidified with the Bad Little Boys. So I went in that direction.
Okay, so you went on the solo tip. Now, what was it like going over to Uptown with Andre Harrell? And I believe this was still at the time when Diddy was doing his A&R over at Uptown with Jodeci and Mary J, right?
Yes.
All right, so what was that like going into Uptown knowing that they had hits with Guy, Jodeci, and Mary J?
Oh, it was exciting. It was an exciting era. The label was small, tight, so everyone basically knew each other. It was like a family, and I loved it. It was quite an experience for me.
Okay, now how did Personality come about?
Personality came about, there was a guy named Jimmy Maynes that used to work for Uptown, and he had stopped working for them. And he formed a production group, which was called the Hitmakers, Kevin Dean actually produced the track and a few others. So JoJo Grimm actually helped Kevin Dean put together the drum programming on the song. And they approached me, approached my A&R with the track, and my A&R loved it. But there was no lyrics to it at the time. And when we was driving back from from their home, we actually wrote the song, driving back. It was like, just came up with the hook, and from there on, it went on. And Andre Harrell was excited when he heard, the track, and he heard the finished product. He was very excited, and he couldn't hold on to the track. He couldn't wait for the album to be complete.
Right. And I believe in the previous conversation we had that the reaction of the people when it dropped, it was like, yo, this Latin cat is doing like New Jack and hip hop soul, and it was like, it was nuts.
Yeah, it definitely created a buzz. And when I went, I was doing a promotional tour down south. I went to Louisville, Kentucky, Memphis, Tennessee, Atlanta, South Carolina. And it was like the people actually, they they were very nice, you know, like, they really loved the song. They was asking about, like, when is the album coming out. I mean, it did create a buzz.
Yeah, so why no album?
Well, what happened was back in under this, it was totally different than today. Like, everything was basically post-tradition. One of the factors was that the album was released on November. I mean, the single was released on November. And when it was released, the album wasn't even halfway finished. The album didn't even, you know, start. The project didn't even start. Andre was so excited, he just wanted to put it out there. You know, Uptown was hot, so he felt like, hey, I put this out here, I'm Andre Harrell, you know, it's going to hit regardless, even if we put the album out later on. And that's what kind of hurt it a little, because people was rushing to the stores looking for the album. Every time I perform somewhere, they'll come up to me and ask me, hey, you know, how can I get the album? I went to whatever, the Virgin Mega Store or whatever, and I can't find the album. Then I had to explain to them that, you know, we didn't start the project yet. But what happened was, the other factor that kind of hurt it also was that, when I say traditional, back in the days, when right around that time, it's like that, the holidays, you know, after Thanksgiving, Christmas, you know, and a lot of people back in the days used to put out Christmas albums. They don't really do that as much anymore today, because radio stations are different now. They play, you know, even throughout Christmas time, they still play, you know, regular songs. But back in the days, it was tradition. Around the holidays, they would play Nat King Cole, a lot of old, you know, Christmas holiday songs. And everyone would put out Christmas albums. Well, at that time, Personality was actually, it was out around the wrong time. And another reason why it was out at the wrong time was because the labels back then would go out, like, they would go on vacation and they would come back the second week of January. So there was really no one pushing it at the time. So in actuality, imagine if Personality really had a push behind it. It created a buzz on its own, you know. The album at that time, like, everything took so long to come out, that when the album was completed, they had a different project, which was Christopher Williams, and they had to put that project out because they had bought Christopher Williams for, they had paid $1 million to buy him off of Geffen, and MCA, you know, which were over, you know, MCA was overseeing everything that Uptown was doing. It was, applying the pressure on Andre Harrell. So Andre had to stop everything. Because there was a few projects. It wasn't just only mine. You had Horace Brown's project. You had Biggie, you know, before Puff left and took him, you know, with him to have stuff. You had Biggie, Horace Brown, and...
Lost Boys?